paper. I'm drawn in by paper. I like the color and the pattern and the texture, and especially, really especially, when there's metallic accents. So you'll understand why I'm pretty darn excited about the papers I have for you today. They're manufactured in Japan. I have an assortment of Chiyogami. Most of them have metallic accents. Then there's some tissue and hemp and some Uzumaki papers as well. When we post them to the website, we're going to include whether or not there's metallic flex or metallic accents on them. It's a little hard to see based on the photos, and we want you to be aware of what you're getting. Now, the really good news, besides how fabulous these papers are, is that we're going to have them on introductory special. They'll be priced at 20% off. I had a really good time, so let me show you a couple of the things that I worked with. Now, this one, you're going to see me try desperately to put this together. And I was trying really hard to put it together. You can see the spine is a different color, with just some white washi tape, because I knew I wasn't going to leave it the way that it was, but I wanted to give you an idea, a mock-up of what this could look like. So this is the inside, and I'm hoping it doesn't fall apart as I open it. And it did. So really, what I'm trying to do is just give you an idea. This is a 4.5 by 6, I think, that's oriented horizontally. I could have turned the papers and oriented it vertically, but I haven't made a horizontal journal in a while, and I thought that that would be fun. So included are some wonderful, wonderful papers that you'll see. Again, I'm just going to give you a little brief overview here. I'm going to show them to you kind of one at a time, but not too much, because otherwise it'll take forever. But there is a really pretty nice assortment, and those metallic accents are pretty awesome. We also have some sets or some assortments. There's two that are pastel, one that's bright, and one that is metallics. And each of these assortments that are the pastels or the brights, you can see right there, there's a metallic sheet in each. And then I didn't have a lot of time to play, but I did want to show you this. It's really easy to use these. You can use them pretty much, it's paper, so you can use them however you want. Let's go take a look at these marvelous papers, and I'll show you again just a few things that you can do with them. This initial shipment includes 13 styles of Chiyogami paper. There's a little bit of hemp and some tissue, plus a nice group of Uzumaki. There's really a lot to try to page through and show you one at a time, but I'm just going to quickly go through here. Now, the one thing I do want to do is hold these up to the light so that you can see the gold. It's a little harder to see in the photos, which is why when we name these products on the website, there'll be an indicator in that product name about whether or not there's gold accents on there. In some cases, it's a ton. Like, this is a beautiful paper. It's filled with gold. In others, it's a little bit less. Like, you see this one here has some gold on it, but it's not nearly as in your face. And then some of them, like this, have no gold at all. But these really are lovely papers. There's a variety of colors and styles. I mean, flowers are very, very prominent in Japanese papers and Japanese art. So, of course, that's what a lot of what you're seeing here. Then there's ones like this. This one really fascinated me. I like the colors. I like the very vertical orientation. And there's just little gold dots in the center there that I thought was fun. And then we'll finish it up with a really pretty deep purple. So that's the Chiyogami. When we bring out some of these other ones, and again, there's a variety of them here, these really cool tissues. You can see that there's little metallic flakes. So I have this one in gray, if I could separate it. We have it in black with the same metallic flex, and then there's white, same kind of deal. And then we have these other papers, and there's a piece of something else floating around in here. I've kind of lost track of which are which, but you can see that we have this one in both off-white and white, really, really pretty. And then we have this circular design that I was fascinated with. You can see I've used a chunk of this one. And we have this in several styles as well, or several colors as well. So there's a lot here to play with and to choose from. The other thing that we have, just to give you a little bit more to choose from, we have four assortments. I'm going to start with the metallic because that's the one that's the most different. This includes, let me just make certain that I get my notes, looking at my notes. This includes two pieces. You can see there's a gold here and a full-size piece of silver on the back that are 6 by 8.5. And then the rest of these, and I'm going to pull them out so you can see them, are a variety of sizes for a total of 6 papers. Oops. So again, really nice patterning. These are textured, some of them a little bit more heavily than others, but these are really, really pretty papers. And then when you look at the assortments, this one is the brights. Well, it would help if I turned it the right way, wouldn't it? This one is the brights. You can see all the styles in there. And there's a variety of papers. There's the regular Chiyogami, as well as some of these others that I don't exactly know what they are. And on the back, you get this really nice piece of textured paper. It reminds me very much like linen. When we look at this one, this is pastel number one. And on the back, it has really pretty green. You can see that there's a variety of colors and styles and papers. And then this one is pastel. This is pastel number two. Each of these assortments, as you look, one, two, and then three, they all include one piece of metallic paper. So there's a lot here to really work with. Now, anything you can do with regular paper, you can do with these. You can cut, you can tear, you can die cut. You can cut with a rotary cutter and ruler, which is what I tend to do. You can pretty much do anything with them. They really are nice papers. So this is a 6x6 piece of cardstock that has one of Rebecca Meyer's rice papers on the back. And then I put this on here, and this is just a circle I die cut. And I'm thinking about putting this in the center so it really focuses the attention. And I could cut a smaller circle of this and also put it in the center. Not really certain where I'm going with this, but I have some ideas. This is a journal page, and you'll recognize this because Caroline Duncan's... Nope, I take that back. You won't see this till Friday. This is coming. Just be patient. It'll be here. But I used one of these with the circular design. In fact, this is the one that I used. You can see that right here. So I've stuck that back here. They make great layers. You could use this as an entire background on a journal page, any of these, if you wanted to. And then finally, I liked the idea of taking little bits of several papers and combining them. Now, it might seem contradictory to use these somewhat elegant papers. This is one of Marlene's luxury paper elements from the last release. It's Animals. I don't remember exactly what it was called. But even though it seems a little incongruous, I felt like this whole thing worked together. So the last thing I have to show you is a journal cover and spine that is more or less ready to go. So I used, this is intended to be the outside and the spine. And I set this up as a horizontal orientation rather than portrait. So all I'm going to do, and you can see I've reversed the papers here. All I'm going to do is put these together very lightly with some washi because I don't want to take this apart. I'm not sure where I'm going with this. But I don't want to take this apart and discover that it tears the papers. Well, that just tangled on itself because that wouldn't be good. So, well, that's too short. So not exactly batting a thousand here. Well, alrighty then. So obviously I've got to leave a little bit of space in order to make this close properly. And again, I'm just going to haphazardly put this together because I'm not certain what I'm doing, but it won't be this white. This is just enough to give you an idea of what this could look like. And then if we flip it over, I can put some washi on the other side. Well, alrighty then, in my effort to not have this tape grab too much, it's clearly not grabbing enough at all. Okay, I'm feeling like the village idiot here, so just give me 1 second to fix this. Okay, now hopefully this will hold enough so that I can flip it over. There we go. Again, just get a piece measured here. This is crooked, but it's coming apart anyway, so I'm not too worried about it. I just want to mock it up so you get a sense. Oh my goodness, I am all thumbs. So that you get a sense of what this could look like as a journal cover. Did you ever have one of those days where you're all thumbs? That's exactly how I'm feeling today. So ignoring the fact that this is overhanging, yep, it's not going to go. You know what? At this point, I'm not going to fight it. You get the sense of where I'm going with this. So this will turn like this. Nope, it's not going to do it. But this will be my cover set. This really was just meant to be an example so that you could see some other ways to use these papers. Like I said, there isn't really anything that you can't do with them. And here is my cover set horizontally.